You are the one that teaches people how to treat you.
Nothing's gonna bring me
It's Wednesday the 11th. I feel like I want to start vlogging, even though I don't know what this video is going to be yet. I've been starting to sort of plan my videos more in advance. There's some series that I want to start doing, as well as, yeah, like I just have a few videos that I've wanted to do for a long time, but I haven't got around to doing, and so I really wanted to plan them while I'm here in Paris and before I move to Iceland in July. I don't know why that made me laugh so much. I'm just so happy. I think it's gonna be so fun. So I think I'm just gonna start like vlogging and then maybe make like a whole, do like one big vlog each month. And yeah, I guess that's the start of that. So let me set you down. Perfect. God, I don't know why I'm so smiley today. Yesterday, I hung out with my friend Ina, who is a French YouTuber, but she's also an artist. And yeah, we were in the park that I live really close to. I don't know if you guys know this, but I live on the left bank of Paris, so it's sort of like old Paris with beautiful buildings, and I just always love going to this park that's close to where I live. And yeah, we did laughing therapy. That's something that I love to do with my friends. It just makes me so happy, and afterwards it's such a release. So usually, I think I've talked about this, but you just get in a group and one of you starts laughing like crazy and then it makes everyone laugh. But she had a new one, which is like you shake hands and then you start laughing, and we were laughing so hard. And yeah, I just feel like I've had a lot of time recently to grow. I think like since I've started doing my yoga practice, I've been doing it like every day. I just feel so much more aligned in my body. Tomorrow I'm going to interview my friend who's a painter, and I want to interview her about her life. I have a class tonight, a fitness class. Hey, it's about to be summer, you guys. I'm on my fitness shit. Sometimes I've been feeling a little bit overwhelmed and like I've been spreading myself thin, because I think this is like the most projects I've ever done in one given time. For example, in one time, I'm working on music, and that also means like the music videos, because I'm collaborating with people on the music videos. So like we're having like Zoom calls and talking about that kind of stuff. My second book, which I don't know, like it's I really love it and I'm having so much fun working on it. But it's a lot more difficult than I thought it was gonna be, because there's a lot of like graphic design elements to it, and yeah, and I keep getting like errors from the self-publishing format stuff. Anyway, I don't know if that's interesting to you guys, but then there's that. I also have my YouTube channel, which I'm trying to be very consistent with. And then I have the Instaplay, which I've sort of fallen behind on, because, and then I'm doing an art show in the end of July, so it's like four projects all at once. And I do normally like to work on a lot of different things at once. I think it gives you a lot of energy, but at the same time I do find myself like looking at the computer a lot and not giving myself time to just enjoy life. And so I think that maybe like my new system is gonna be like in the first half of every year I'm like grinding on projects, and then the second half I'm releasing them, and then like maybe just trying to enjoy life more. I don't know, it's really hard to find the balance, I think. And like I think another part of it is like I don't have a relationship right now, and so I do have more time to do that, so I am trying to really focus on all the things I want to do. But yeah, I was telling this to my friend Ina yesterday, who I said is like the French YouTuber, that I feel like part of it is my fault, because I put deadlines on myself that I don't need to. Like, I don't know why, but I told people, for example, for the Instaplay, like, this time around, it's gonna be just 1 month until everyone sends their stuff in and I'm done editing. Which is, I've already passed that deadline. And also, it's not good for me. Like, why did I have to do that? There was like part of me that needed to like tell people that I was working on this thing in order to like pressure myself. But that's not cool. That's not what we're trying to do. I think that's a really big theme as well. I think for this month for me in May is boundaries. I think that there's been a few really flagrant, that's not a word. There's been a few big instances for me where I was like, I feel like my boundaries have been crossed in some ways, and not necessarily like in the ways that you would think. For example, it could be like hanging out with somebody new, like a friend that I just met, and then seeing a behavior from them that I don't necessarily agree with, and knowing that I should say something but also not, because I feel like maybe it's not, that's so vague, but also I don't like calling people out. Like, I don't want to do that. Yeah, I am working on, I'm on a self-love journey. As I think we all should be. I think that so often in life as well, we think like that it's somebody else that's gonna fix all of the problems that we have, or like it's gonna make us happier, when in reality, I think that the more you work on yourself and get yourself to a place that you feel really good, then the more people you can meet on that level, like leveling up, I guess, you know? How are you guys doing? How are you feeling? We had a Patreon party the other day and everyone was talking about how I do like these little prompts with them, and I asked like, what is the thing that you think from last month that brought you the most joy, and what drained you the most, and like, what is your word for May? So my word for May is intentional, because I'm trying to be very intentional, and I felt like everyone that I talked to in that little small group that we had, I think another big theme for people like talking about our projects and things is this feeling of wanting to put yourself out there and do things, but then having this like small little thing in your head telling you like, who are you to do this thing? Like, why should you think that you are able to do this? You know, like discouraging yourself. This is another thing that I was talking to my friend about the other day, and she was asking me like if I ever have that anymore. And I think like certainly over certain projects, for example, I don't have that like around like art anymore or writing, but you know, like for example, music, I have never put out music before, and so it's something totally different. And but at the same time, I think that the desire to want to create something is always bigger than the fear of failure. Also, at the end of the day, I've learned to not take myself too seriously and to look at every project as just fun, like I'm having fun. And I think that sometimes we can get too wrapped up in the end result of things. For example, even like my music and stuff, I could get wrapped up in, oh, like I hope people like it, I hope, but at the same time, like if they don't, oh well, like I learned so much doing it, and I had, it really helped me through a difficult time in my life. So I would say that for you guys, with anything that you want to do or try, just like really fall in love with the process and really just give yourself permission to fail. I feel like the more times you put yourself out there, the more you realize that the risk is always worth it, because even if you fail, like you learn something. And overcoming that, overcoming adversity, every time you do that, you gain confidence. I think that's why people who travel, like solo travel, have so much confidence. People who start, you know, people who put themselves in situations where they have to overcome something realize that they can rely on themselves, and it gives them confidence. So yeah. Oof, girly. I thought this was gonna be a vlog. You've been talking for 15 minutes. Okay. Anyway, this is the chatty portion of the video. Another thing that I was sort of struggling with this month, and that I had to kind of come to terms with through a lot of journaling. If ever you guys feel like overwhelmed, I just would so recommend journaling. It just makes you feel like, oh, like I have this space for myself, I can count on myself. And I think the important thing is to not judge what you're journaling. Like, don't try to journal and make it good writing. You know what I mean? I know it's hard because, especially as creative people, we want everything we do to be like beautiful and cool. But yeah, like honestly, sometimes the things that I write in my journal, I can't even read my own handwriting. I'm like, girl, like, it looks like you like scratched this in. But yeah, something that I came to terms with this month and I was writing about a lot in my journal is feeling like I tend to attract people in my life who are, this sounds so fucked up. I tend to attract people who, and I don't mean like romantically, I mean like friendships, just like people into my life, like all generally. Who are kind of more like self-centered, and I end up like at first maybe like the friendship is sort of equal, but then after a while I think because I am so empathic and I want to be there for them, and I sort of realized about myself that I tend to always try whenever I hang out with other people to bring their energy up and make them feel better and like try to encourage them and stuff. But there were certain times when maybe like I was having a bad day that I felt like I couldn't show that because I felt like I was responsible for the energy. I listened to the Armchair Expert podcast, and the guy who hosts it, Dax, was talking about how, like, for example, if he's in an elevator alone with somebody else, he would feel like he would have to be the one to like make it less awkward or like say something, you know? And I feel like in the past, I've sort of been like that. Like I've always taken on the responsibility in relationships to bring the other person up, and to also carry the conversation, ask all the questions. And oftentimes I would feel like I would attract people into my life who wouldn't necessarily like reciprocate that. I had to like really sit with myself and ask why I continue to not only attract but allow myself to sort of be like the supporting character a lot of times, when in reality, like, I'm a fucking badass artist. I'm doing a lot of interesting and cool things, and I should feel like my life is also important to other people. I feel like in a relationship, you're always, both people are getting something out of it, or else you wouldn't be hanging out, you know what I mean? So I had to ask myself, like, what is it about this relationship? Like, why do I put up with this sort of thing, even though oftentimes I leave feeling drained? And then I had to sort of come to terms with the fact that maybe I have been attracting those types of people and wanting to hang out with them because maybe I didn't want to take up space. Maybe it was easier than having to talk about my own life, and maybe that gave me anxiety a little bit, you know. But also I think like it like comes back to childhood, when I felt like the way that I got validation is sort of being like the entertainer and not having like problems. Like, you know, when you are in a family, like a bigger family, you feel like, and you know, you don't want to, yeah, like there's already like enough problems and things, and so you don't want to like talk about your, you feel like you don't, you can't take up space in that way, you know what I mean? And so I often felt like maybe in friendships I was sort of reliving that, where I felt like my sort of role and like what I could give was just like joy, but I wouldn't give myself the same right to have a bad day or feel sad. And the problem with that is that real connection is forged when two people share their life, you know what I mean? Not just you hang out with somebody, you listen to their things, etc., etc. Real connection is forged when both people are able to open up. But I feel like in a lot of instances, I wasn't able to do that. Or I would, if this, if the attention was turned on me, I sort of like would put up a block in a way, which is so weird because of the job that I do. The job that I do, like, I feel like I'm so open and stuff online. But also because I don't feel like there is this like presence here, like somebody else who I need to focus all of my attention on. It's sort of like this very vague thing. I don't know. And so I really took a lot of time that month, this month, to think about that and like think about how, yeah, like how I, like the roles that I accept to play in other people's lives, when in reality, like, I'm the fucking main character, bitch. Like, we should all be the main character in our own life. And so that way, when you're hanging out with another main character, you guys are like two stars of the show. You know, I think that as well. It doesn't mean that they're like bad people, but I do feel like, I feel like at the same time, it's important to, that if you do try to take up more space and the other person isn't like allowing you to do so, then maybe you should invest in other relationships. That's why affirmations are so important, I feel like. Like, every time I feel down, I write affirmations and they bring me up. Like, I know where I belong, bitch. I know where I belong. And after like a particularly strange weekend where I just like left feeling like, and this is, I feel like all empaths can relate to this. You're just like so giving of your attention and your time that you can often feel like, yeah, like you're, especially if you're hypersensitive, you can often feel like very, you pay a lot of attention to where your energy goes and stuff. And so another thing that I realized is the reason why I love spending so much time alone is because I don't, when I'm by myself, like I love myself and I have so much fun with myself and we go on little adventures. But when I'm with somebody else, I feel this obligation, like when I was younger, to always be like, I said, like the fun one, bringing light, bringing, which I feel like I do naturally, but at the same time, like there's this like social thing that I feel, and it's not with everybody, but with the majority of people. So I prefer to be alone, and that's the truth. That's why I love being alone, because when I'm alone, I don't feel like I have to, I don't feel like I have to try and like fill in the spaces. And that's something I've been trying to work on too, is like realizing like, when you're with people, like, you don't always have to take on the responsibility of like making things less awkward. Like, you can let tension arise in the spaces in between and stuff like that. But anyway, I was having sort of a strange weekend where I just felt like very undervalued, I guess. Like, I don't know, that can happen in life. So I wrote in my journal, how to be the main fucking character. And some of the things that I wrote are, okay, dress the part. So, would the main character wake up and not put in an effort? No. The main character dresses in things that are like, make them feel good. You know what I mean? Like, I love, lately I've been putting in gel in my hair and like really, people have been telling me lately that I look like a 90s cartoon character. And just like having fun with makeup. This week I made a list of fun things that I want to do. Like, I'm going to do like a fun photo shoot with myself if I have time. if I have time. Another one that I put is boundaries. Bitch, boundaries. And I think the trick to this is to set your boundaries before you enter in any sort of compromising situation. And it doesn't have to be like something big, like, oh, this person passed me a joint and I don't feel like smoking tonight, you know what I mean? But I said yes because they pressured me. It doesn't have to be something like that. It could be like, oh, I'm tired, I don't want to go out, but I'm saying yes because I feel like if I don't, people are gonna be mad at me. Well, so what? If they're mad at you for not wanting to go out just because you're tired, well then they're not real friends anyway. Like, don't put everyone else's needs before your own. And I think that having like those core values and things you will and will not accept and like try to write some of this out can really help you in situations where you're forced to, Yeah, to like sort of deal with that kind of stuff. Because I think it's really hard to have boundaries when you're just sort of like on the spot. Oh shit, like I don't want to do this, but I haven't practiced like what I do in this situation. You know, and I think also knowing what to say, like you can say things like, no, I'm sorry, I can't do that right now. Like, I'm sorry, I won't do that. We oftentimes think that people will respect us less if we say no, because we think like the word no is mean. When in reality, people respect you more when you have boundaries. So dress the part, boundaries. Also like focusing on your projects. You know, I think a lot of times in my life, because I want to see my friends succeed so much, I would oftentimes like put a lot of like encouragement on the things they're doing, which is great. You should definitely do that. But it shouldn't be at the expense of your own things, you know? So I wrote that one on there. Value your time. Value your time. Value your time. There's nothing that I hate more than getting my time wasted. I like literally, like as somebody is, like I said, that has so many projects going on. Yeah, like if somebody, and this is sort of like special in Paris, if somebody's like 30 minutes late to meeting me, I'll be like, look, you don't, maybe like we just met, I'll be like, you don't know me that well yet, but like I'll take you being late this time, but like if you're late again, I won't hang out with you, because it's just like fucking rude, you know what I mean? And like I get it, you can be like 10 minutes late or here and there, but if someone's like fucking 30 minutes late, I'm sorry, like no. You know, this also comes back to the thing of like, you are the one that teaches people how to treat you. And so if you are arriving in a relationship and you aren't like showing people that you actually want to take up more space, and you're just letting them talk and you're not saying like, hey, like don't you want to know about my life, or like not voicing that, then you're just teaching them that you're okay with just being like the venting box or whatever, you know? Like, listen, girlies, I'm saying this for me as much as I'm saying it for you. We're fucking badass motherfuckers. Like, we are artists, we are taking up space, and we should support each other, love each other, but also like have enough respect for your inner child to realize that they're so special that they should be the only main character on their own life, you know? So anyway, wow, I wasn't expecting this like sit down for all of this to come out. I thought this was gonna be a vlog, but I guess this video is gonna be like probably like how to become the main character in your own life. Ugh, I don't know, YouTube is testing me. Like, I feel like I have to always like title things a certain way, but also like, yeah, we want to help people and connect. So yeah, anyway, I guess like this was a longer chat than I anticipated. I guess the vlog will have to come another time, but don't worry, like there will be many vlogs and things. But yeah, I sort of felt that like on my heart that maybe a lot of people struggle with this, especially like, if you're empathic and sensitive. And it's also like a little hard for me to share, especially as somebody who wants to be seen as a strong and also like, yeah, like someone who wants to be seen as strong and inspiring, to say that like sometimes I also struggle with that, because, you know, oftentimes like that is the sort of like double-edged sword with vulnerability. Like it helps for people to connect with you and understand you better, but also there's this part that like, oh, will people use this against me? But I have trust that this community is bienveillant, as we say in French. You guys are like all loving, and so like, honestly, if I was gonna have a problem with that kind of shit, I would have already had it. So anyway, just some like food for thought, and I hope this could be inspiring to you guys who are also doing, you know, going through similar things, similar seasons in your life. And let's end on this. Today's my lucky day. Okay, I love you guys to the moon and back. If you made it to the end, leave me a comment that says, friends forever, baby. Okay. And also, let me know if you guys are going anywhere this summer, what your plans are. And also, before I forget, because I always do, if you guys want to come to meetups this summer, you can join my Patreon. We have Paris meetups. We have the Paris Dinner Club. We're doing apartment swaps. We have Zoom parties. There's podcast episodes. So I just forget to plug it. But if you guys are looking for more like in-depth community time, we have that over there. Some people have really become like besties and stuff who also like found out they live in the same city. So I think that's really cool. And I also have a poetry book out. So you guys can check that out down below, art prints, and I'm working on my second book that I hope will be out very soon. So yeah, I love you guys, and I'll talk to you very soon. Bye! As I'm editing this, I just wanted to add another thank you for holding space for me and making me feel like I can share online with you guys. I know that most of you will never have the opportunity to meet in real life, but our relationship online means so much to me, and being able to be a part of each other's journeys as we grow and learn in life, it's one of my greatest joys. So thank you so much for holding space for me, for being kind, and for being my friend. Anyway, I love you and have a beautiful week. Bye.